We're here with Max Michel, who is the team captain of the SIG team. Max is a multiple world champion pistol shooter, and we recently ran a video where he did a stunning accomplishment, putting 18 rounds on three targets with mag changes all in under 5 seconds. Max, I ran that video, and comments were along the lines of unbelievable, stupendous, mind-boggling. So how did you do it?
I ate my Wheaties that morning. Now, I tell you, a lot of work goes into that. That's one of my favorite drills to run for demonstrational purposes. But there's so much that goes involved in it, you know, from the drawing the handgun from a holster, you have to spend hours upon hours learning the technical aspects of that. But more importantly, the stance and the grip. You know, when you watch that video, you just kind of see it all happen, but you don't really, it's kind of the behind the scenes part of it. Because it's really about the recoil management. Being able to shoot 18 shots in 5 seconds without reloading or drawing is difficult. So kind of when you add the two reloads and the draw, well now, in reality, you're shooting probably 15 rounds in less than 2 seconds. And that's pretty difficult to do. But, you know, again, it goes into that stance and grip, recoil management, the draws, the reloads, so much goes into that. But when I practice and when I train, a lot of times people ask me, how do I do that? How do I accomplish it? It's really, truly, most of my training is done at half speed. When I train, I do things at half speed. So that way I can know and really teach myself the kind of the step-by-step, by the numbers, how to make things happen. You know, if you go fast in everything you do, you're only going to remember two things, and that's the beginning and the end. So for me, if I can go about 50% speed, 70% of my training, believe it or not, I can learn those things and then build in that muscle memory. So when it is time to go fast, I can just simply react. I don't have to think about anything.
How many hours have you put in over decades to reach the level you're at now?
Yeah, I would say countless hours. You know, especially when I first started, I was very young. I started competing when I was 8 or 9 years old, and I really got a passion for what I do at a very young age, and I didn't have anything else to do. I'd go to school, and I would come home, and I would train. And when I was home, I would dry fire. And I would dry fire 4 hours every day, pretty much, and learning various techniques of how and why the firearms operate the way that they do, and how I might be able to operate them more effectively. So I would say that's very accurate, and for me, geez, I mean, I couldn't put a number on it. It's been well over, you know, I would say just over 20 years now I've been competing, and I've been very, very serious about it for over 15 years now, and it's been my full-time job, so it's quite the hours.
Now, a lot of people would say you're the fastest man in the world with a pistol, but a young lady recently became a grandmaster, is that correct?
That's correct.
Can Jessie beat you?
Next question. No, sure. No, she's a great shooter, and you know, she made grandmaster, first female ever to do that. That's absolutely exceptional. And it's funny because, you know, a lot of times in most sports, you know, guys don't look at girls as threats and call it sexist, call it what you will. That's, you know, football players are not gonna, you know, be threatened by women or whatever the case is. You see that from time to time, but she's the exception in our sport, and guys are gonna start noticing her. And if they haven't yet, they will be seeing her pretty soon.